Hachette Audio presents Sci-Fi Junior High, written by John Martin and Scott Seegert, read by Nate Begle.
Prologue.
It's nearly mine! Blah!
Whoa! What have I gotten myself into? A few days earlier. Day one. One. Seriously? Mom and Dad expect me to get up and go to school the morning after a 329 quadrillion mile road trip across the galaxy? And I'm not even a morning person to begin with. I can't fake being sick either. Not with the sterile environment of the space station. No germs equals no sickness. Ever. Not even the sniffles. At least I got a good night's sleep. The zero-gravity pods in our live spaces are way more comfortable than regular beds. And you can sleep standing up, so they take up less space. Oh, hold on a second. I guess I should explain. My name is Kelvin, and I'm about to start my first day at a new school, which is nothing new to me. Our family moves around a lot, and this is my fourth new school in the past 5 years. It's just that this one is 56,000 light-years from the last one. My mom and dad are scientists, really smart ones, which is why we're moving around all the time. They keep getting new projects to work on, and we have to go where the projects are. In this case, that's the other end of the galaxy. Unfortunately, my little sister Beulah had to come along with us. So I guess there really is one germ on this space station. Robotics is Dad's specialty. You may already be familiar with some of his work, like the X9000 Pulverbot he designed for Global Mining Incorporated. Then there's the PL-370 rootin' tootin' asteroid shootin' bot he created to keep foreign objects from colliding with the Earth. And of course, the Niven 6000 all-terrain, fully armored, nuclear-powered rescue bake bot. Dad feels that anyone in dire need of rescue must also be in dire need of a warm, freshly baked chocolate chip cookie. Then there's my mom. She's a neuroscientist, which means she plays around with brains. No, not like that. She works with the brains while they're still inside the heads. At least, that's what she tells me. Although it would be pretty cool to have an evil scientist for a mom. Since my mom and dad are both super geniuses, that obviously makes me a super genius too, right? Nope. It makes me a double super genius, or what I like to call a mighty mega super genius. It also makes me the smartest human being in the world. There's really no arguing the fact. It's simple math. Our new home is called the Galactic Science Hub. The top two scientists from more than 200 different planets live aboard it with their families. So do all the other workers and their families. It's huge! It's in the middle of space, and it's the first place I've ever lived aboard instead of in. We haven't even been here a day yet, but like I said, the zero-gravity pods are awesome. The showers, though, not so much. We have to be careful how much water we use on the space station, so we clean up using this thing called a Vacu-Suck 3000. Sure, it sucks all the dirt off your body. It even sucks all the dirt off your clothes. But no way is it as relaxing as a hot shower. Plus, you have to hold your breath for 15 seconds. Plus, you really have to work the hair gel when you're done. But so far, so good, I guess. Most days, I'll take the shuttle bus over to the school they set up for all the kids on the science hub. It's sort of its own separate mini space station. Fortunately, The older kids have their own school, so we don't have to deal with them very often. Even better, the little kids, like Beulah, stay aboard the science hub and out of our hair. Since it's my first day, though, Mom is taking me in. Normally, this would be a major bag-over-the-head situation, but I get to go in a little late so we can meet with Principal Ort before I go to class. I figure the hallway should be mostly empty if we get there before class lets out, so as long as I keep my head down and slink along the walls, no one should see us together. "Come on, Mom!" I yell. "I don't want to be late for my meeting!" "I'll just be a minute," she yells back from the bathroom. "I think it's great that you're so excited to get started at your new school, Kelvin." Actually, not so much excited as worried that hundreds of kids' first impressions of me will be the dweeb who has to have his mommy bring him to school, I say, very quietly, to myself. Nothing could be worse. "Okay, Kelvin. I'm ready to go." "Okay. This is worse. Mom," I say, "your, hair is..."
"I know, isn't it wonderful? And I didn't even have to do anything to get it this way. I just love that VacuSuck 3000. Please, 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 can we get to school before class lets out?"
2. So, this is it. Sci-Strati Fibrinocularius Junior High School. I'm not really sure how to pronounce it, but Dad says everybody just calls it Sci-Fi Junior High.
The whole way over here, I've been trying to come up with a plan to keep Mom from coming into school with me, and I think I've got it. All I need is a flashlight, a jetpack, 3 gallons of blueberry yogurt, 40 feet of high-strength fishing line, and a bucket of...
"You know what, Kelvin? Why don't you just go ahead into your meeting without me?"
"Golf balls."
"I'm sure the last thing you need is to be seen with your mom on your first day, right?"
Clomp. That was my jaw dropping open and hitting the floor.
"I'll just stop in and talk to the principal later this afternoon. Have a great day. Oh, and don't forget your helmet."
I can't believe it. It worked. My plan actually worked. And I didn't even have to, you know, use it. Now, to play it cool. I don't want to seem too happy she's not coming in and hurt her feelings. "You sure, Mom? It's really not a big deal."
"Really? Well, in that case, I suppose I could stop in for a minute or two and..."
"No! I mean, you don't have to do that. I'm sure you're real busy with whatever it is you're working on. I'll be fine."
"All right, sweetie. You have a great first day."
Yikes.
Now I kinda wish she was here.
Starting at a new school, with a weird name, in the middle of outer space. What was I thinking wanting to do this by myself? What if I get lost? What if I accidentally wander off this artificial gravity platform and drift off into space? What if my helmet cracks and my head implodes while I'm standing out here thinking about all the horrible things that could happen? I'd better get inside the entrance airlock. 3. I sure hope Principal Ort is in his office. Or is it her office? Guess I'll find out soon enough. This looks like it. I press the button on the door, and an eyeball appears. "It's Kelvin Klosmo," I say. "I'm a new student, and..."
Yes, the eyeball interrupts. "Mr. Klosmo, come right in and have a seat. We've been expecting you."
The door slides open, and I step inside. Still no idea whether he is a she or she is a he. Or both. Or neither.
"Hello, Kelvin. My name is Principal Ort, and I must say that we are very pleased to have you here at Sci-Strati Fibrinocularius Junior High School. Very pleased. Tremendously pleased. Extraordinarily pleased."
"Wow. Thanks, I guess. But how do you even know who I am?"
who you are. Why, you're Kelvin Klosmo, the only student in the entire school who has both parents serving as scientists on the space station. Which means, of course, that your parents are the two most brilliant scientific minds on your entire planet. I can't even imagine what a genius you must be. We're expecting incredible things from you, young man. Incredible things. Magnificent things. Splendiferous things.
Uh-oh. Splendiferous? I don't even know what that means.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.